Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to teach you how you can import STL files into Sketchup and edit them. I'm here on Thingiverse, and this is where I love to come to find cool 3D things to print. The STL files in here are great. Sometimes they'll even have Sketchup files, so you don't have to worry about this whole thing. And they're not paying me to say that. Thingiverse is just a really awesome website. I don't know if they make money, if there's a way to even do that on here. So what I'm going to do is just download some STL files, import it, and then show you what we can do to edit it once we have it imported. So we're just going to explore a little bit, see what kind of cool stuff they have. So let's try things, explore popular, see what kind of cool stuff they have. And this is just like a great way to see what things you could print too. It might help generate some ideas for what you might be able to do. Try these guys. These are kind of cool looking. Right, so what you do is you click on that and then you'll see more images. So you can see, like, is this really what I want? There are some views, and you can click the thing of view, which lets you rotate kind of like SketchUp does. So you're like, oh yeah, this is definitely exactly what I want. And so then you click thing files, and they have different files here. So these are like different versions that they uploaded. You can try each one. I'm just going to pick one. Just click that. You can see it downloads in the bottom left here. I'm going to open up my SketchUp. Just dock this over here eventually. There we go. Go to import. And then in here, there's an option for STL right here. Stereolithography files. So I'm going to click that. Go to my downloads folder. Click it. And it's going to bring it in. We've imported our STL file into SketchUp. It's opened, and you can see there's a lot of extra information here that we don't want. All these extra lines. So if we're trying to edit this, it's going to be a huge pain. We have to make a lot more selections than we want to. And we don't want to have to do that. And you can always come in here to the group and press E for the eraser tool, and you can come in. I'm holding control here to select these lines. You can see it's taking a little bit longer than you would think, and delete them. But I don't want to have to do that for all of these, and you don't have to. So I'm going to undo that. And what we're going to do is we're going to use a plugin that will do all of this for us. But before I do that, I just want to show you something. I opened this up before to check and make sure this is going to work. You can see that there are some faces that aren't connected. So this is in the file itself. When it imports, it may have just lost this geometry. The file on Thingiverse looked fine. But maybe the file is just corrupt in some sort of way. So we want to be able to repair that by not having to go through and draw every line. So I'm going to show you how to do that as well. But first, we're going to come in here, go into this group, hit Control-A, Command-A if you're on Mac, to select all. Go to the extensions, and I've installed Cleanup³. So I'm going to go to Clean here. I'm going to make sure the scope is selected. I've taken off Purge Unused. This means it'll delete any components you're not using. Doesn't really matter for this. I think Merge Coplanar Faces, yes. Ignore UV. The really thing that I want is Erase Straight Edges. It's like the most important thing. And Repair Split Edges. So I'm going to hit Clean Up here. It's going to give me an estimated time in the bottom. It thinks it's going to be 14 minutes, but it's just a few seconds, actually. And it fixed some things. So we're good, right? But now these little discrepancies are much clearer. So I'm going to open this. I'm going to select these. Right, just go around, orbit, see what's going on, select all these. And I'm not going to do it for all of these, but you can see I could just come in, draw a line. Let me just show you that real quick. You may need to turn on hidden geometry. That'll give you a little bit of better insight of what the geometry is doing. So if I close this, it'll close. And you could go through and do that for all of them. But I've installed another plugin called Eneroth Face Creator. There'll be a link to these two below, these two plugins that I'm using. I'm just going to select these instances. I'm just going to do a few for now. Say one, these two, right? So I have these instances. I'm going to go to the extensions, Eneroth Face Creator. It's going to take a few seconds to think. And you can see that it made faces where all those little openings were. So that's just a much quicker way than selecting all the lines to do everything. And if you choose the whole thing, it's probably going to mess up. So just do it a little bit at a time. But now it's in here. And if I want to shrink this, I can certainly do that. So if I select all of these faces, let's say I wanted a little bit more variety in how this looks, and I wanted to shrink this, got one more to select, hit S for scale, and then scale this up. So now I have like a different aperture. So that's what we have. If you thought this video was helpful, please don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. We make these videos for you, so let us know if you have any questions about anything in SketchUp or design or architecture in the comments below. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.